Welcome to 4204 Peach Place in Franklin. Come on inside. This lovely four-bedroom, four-bath home features central heat and air, propane heat and gas logs, full finished basement with recreation room, up to four cars possible in the garage or workshop area. Upgraded fixtures throughout, new carpet with premium pad, freshly painted throughout, lots of natural light. Window treatments to remain, oak hardwood floors, very open floor plan. Primary suite is on the main level with vaulted ceilings. Reclaimed natural wood accent wall. Large double closets in the master bath. Great space. Bathroom has been recently updated this year with new vanities, new fixtures, easy roll drawers, tile floor. Jacuzzi tub. Shower and even a private commode closet. Wonderful space for the primary. Now, let's look around a little bit. This is the formal living room with an extra sitting area here. Great planning space or home office. Coat closet, right off the master. Great for storage space. Staircase to the upstairs off the entry. We'll go there after we go through the main level first. In the formal dining room, we have your captured wood ceilings, huge double windows for lots of natural light. All window treatments to remain. The main level is beautiful oak hardwood floors. We have granite countertops in the kitchen. Nice big pantry, floor to ceiling and storage space. Big industrial sink with strainer. And the owner said to make sure you know he has a cutting board that comes with it they've never used. Electric cooktop, built-in oven. Breakfast room is in front of the covered deck. Great house for parties. Then you have a family sitting area off the breakfast room and across from the formal living room. In the back here, you have another full bathroom with tile floors. Laundry room with sliding door, very handy. Electric boxes in the laundry room, stainless storage, and washer and dryer stackables. This is a Google Smart Home, by the way. You can control the lights, thermostats, even the music. This is the second bedroom downstairs, great for guests or family. Has a nice oversized closet with organizer. And tray ceiling. Now, let's take a peek upstairs, but first, look at this bar. Isn't that wonderful? Great for early morning breakfast, snacks, family get-togethers. That's the basement door. First, I want to go upstairs, and then we'll go back to this door. You have a colonnade separating the space on the main level. Now, let's go upstairs. Upstairs has two spacious bedrooms with baths and an extra room for guests, nannies, hobby room. The main upstairs has a balcony that overlooks the living room. Isn't that just awesome? Let me take you to the spare room first. This is the room we don't even count as a bedroom. We count it as a hobby room. That door against the wall has extra storage behind the wall. As you can see, it's a very spacious room with a connector room to the other bedroom. Great nanny room if you need it. Now I'm deliberately taking you in the main space here. Here's the bedroom. Vaulted ceiling, beautiful open windows, and its own private bathroom. Isn't that lovely? With tile floors and shower. This bedroom has a nice oversized closet with double doors. Lots of organizer space. Look at that. Isn't that great? And this room, there's the room we just looked at. Now, let's go back out to the entry upstairs. This storage is where the furnace upstairs is located. It has extra storage above and heavy insulation in the walls. Tell a great temperature difference between the main level. House is well insulated. Second bedroom upstairs. Look at this. Isn't that awesome? Another big double closet. Look at that organizer. Oh, wow. Just great space. And this is for a guest bedroom. I know, right? Go down the hall. Another full bath with a tub shower. Tile floors. Look at that. Vanity. Great space. And at the end of the hall is a workout room, already decked out with a widescreen TV. The whole house is a smart house and it's wired for Ethernet. So you can have streaming videos high speed all throughout the house. You can put in extra boosters in the house for your wireless. It's really well situated. This is not a cool, it's even got a skylight. Hello, it's a great room. Now, let's go downstairs into the basement from one extreme to another. Look at the colonnade. Isn't that beautiful? That TV is negotiable. The art on the wall is even negotiable. It has gas logs in the fireplace. Now, let's take a peek downstairs. Who doesn't love a finished basement? great for storms, making a buffer for guests so they won't make loud noises, which is kind of cool. Look at that. Our carpets were installed recently. The roof, gutters, were installed 3 years ago with HVAC. This they use as a home office on the basement level. Great space. They're already packing a little bit to move, so it's a little more empty than normal, but it still has this treadmill. Brick walls. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Home office. Here's the second furnace. Its own private closet. The owner is a tech man and had said anybody buys this house, if they'd like to have a personal consult on how to work the Google Smart Home, he will do that at no extra cost. This is the playroom. It has a shuffleboard and a pool table that will remain. It's a very spacious room. Isn't this great? Look at the space. No windows, so it's a great storm room too. Now take a peek at the garage. They have used their garage for art studio and garage. So they put a wood floor that just sits on the concrete to make it easier for their projects. But that floor is fully removable and it's suitable for four cars. So depending on whether you need a workshop or four car space, this is, they told me when I looked at the house for the first time, this is the official storm cubby. Reinforced concrete walls. Go back there during a tornado. They have dividers here for the art space, but imagine this all open. Outside door, garage door. Storage bins can remain, they're negotiable. Look at the space in this basement. Isn't that tremendous? Step up. Now, the fun part. I know. We get to go on the deck. They just had it recently stained. This is a great house for families, roommates, someone that just needs space. Part of the deck is covered. It would be very easy to screen in. I mean, very easy. Part of it's uncovered. So if you're a sun baby, plenty of place to lay out. Isn't it beautiful? The house is situated on 1.72 acres, just shy of 2 acres, and it's over 4,100 square feet. The backyard is completely fenced in. So if you have pets that you'd like to have run your yard, this is a great yard for that. They have a dog cubby underneath the deck. Great if you want your dogs to have a run place during the day. They have storage under the deck. Wonderful place to put outdoor lawn equipment. Lawn mowers. Has electricity and an up ramp to keep it off the ground. They have a pool away underneath. They use it for their pull along. Isn't this a beautiful yard? Look at that landscaping. So private too. Now let's walk the land. You gotta see this to believe it. The land is nice and flat. They keep it well mowed and maintained. My owner says, plenty of firewood. They have a fire pit in the back. So if you want to invite friends over, marshmallows and weenie roast, this is the perfect property for that on the back part. It's like a natural park, isn't it? You could just sit back here and relax for hours. And then if you're not careful, poof, up in the sky. Yes, you guessed it. It's a treehouse. We don't guarantee the condition, but hey, who knows? Look at the trees and woods. I feel like I've gone to a national park. There's a shed here that has a ramp built into it for the John Deere tractor. The owner has already told me that that's negotiable. So if you want the John Deere tractor to remain, all you need to do is say, hey, would you leave the John Deere tractor? So the ramp comes down automatically and you can drive your tractor right out of the shed, and there's extra storage shelves in the shed. Look at that. Isn't that great? My owner has agreed to try to wrangle one of his chickens. Chickens are negotiable. Not all the chickens, though. But the owner's willing to leave a few with the coop. Yes, there is a chicken coop. As talk proof. That means there's a cage all the way around it. Look at this beautiful yard. We'll go back to the butterfly retreat at the end. But first, we gotta check on the chickens. They're nestled in the very back of the lot to give them total privacy. And here's my owner with one of his chickens to show you. This coop is very easy to gather the eggs. And what's the chicken's name?
This is Kev Hen. Not Kevin, but Kev Hen.
Kev Hen.
Kev Hen.
And that's the kind of eggs that they have. They do Easter eggs.
She's an Easter egger.
Hi, Kevin. Kev Hen. And they have a solar panel on the top for the chickens.
With an automated door.
With an automated door. Look at the other chickens. They're talking to us. Look. They're talking. Hi, chickens. Now, let's go look at the butterfly retreat. This is my favorite part is this yard. You truly feel like you get a workout when you come to the back of the lawn. Behind the fence is a pond and a large retreat. Makes a good back neighbor. And here we finish up with the butterfly garden. Wonderful to attract butterflies. And the fire pit. Invite friends over, have a nice evening of marshmallows and hot dogs. My name is Karen Hoff with Historic and Distinctive Homes. I'm the listing agent of this beautiful property. If you'd like to have your personal viewing, please contact me. My number is 615-500-4631. That's 615-500-4631. My office number is 615-228-3723, extension 302. Karen Hoff with Historic and Distinctive Homes. Visit my website at karenhoff.com. Thank you for walking through the property.